Okay, we're moving right along. You're now ready to implement an axpy routine. So let's click on it. And remember that the first thing you want to do is to make a copy. Okay, what I'm going to do is I'm going to let you work through this notebook on your own. And then in a little while, I'm going to come back and I'm going to show you how I would have written the for loops. And then you can check my answer to your answer yourself. See you in a little while. All right, hopefully you've had a chance to get those for loops written, and hopefully they worked for you. So let's see what I would have done. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go to the point where the first for loop needs to be written. That's right here. And I'll click in this box, and then I can go up here to cell, and I can say run all above, which means that all of those executable cells that were above this particular cell are executed so that we have vectors x and y and scalar alpha. All right, now let's see. So, what do we need to do? Well, remember I like to cut and paste, so where it says insert your loop here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to cut and paste this loop that is conveniently right above it. Now, it is the case that values of y need to be updated, but they need to be updated by multiplying alpha times the corresponding component of x, and adding that then to the component of y. Let's execute this and see what happens. And bingo, we got the right answer. Now, okay, so let's take this loop that we just wrote. Let's take it down to where the routine needs to be written. We'll enter this right here. But notice that I actually am asking you to do a little bit more, because we need to determine what the row and column size of x and y are, and we'll just assume that the row and column size of x and y are the same. So we'll say m and n is equal to np dot shape of, oh, we'll pick vector x, and then if we execute this, what we want to do is say for I in range m, because I has the range from 0 to m minus 1. We'll do a shift return on that, and then we can execute this box to check whether we got the right answer, and bingo, we did. So, what have you learned? This time you had to actually extract the row and column size of a matrix yourself, and all you had to do was insert this for loop, which looks very similar to the ones that were written in the other notebooks. As usual, the Laugh library also provides you with an axpy routine. And finally, if you want a challenge, write yourself an axpy that works with vectors x and y that are row or column vectors, and also checks parameters and does things like that.